Hey, church family, I wanted to take this opportunity to present you with another word of encouragement as we continue to watch the end times unfolding right before our very eyes. Now, for reasons I've never fully grasped, Drag Queen Story Hour is actually a thing, and it's a thing that began in San Francisco back in 2015. In order to understand my confusion, it'll help you to know that Drag Queen Story Hour, it's just as it sounds. It's a children's event that typically takes place at a public library as a drag queen shows up and begins reading children's books to the kids that are gathered together. And these books, well, they oftentimes feature LGBTQ characters and issues. That's right. Since 2015, these Drag Queen Story Hour events have been taking place at public libraries, even public schools, all with the goal of helping kids to become more tolerant and more inclusive of this community. Here's how the mission is described on the website of the Drag Queen Story Hour. They put it like this. DQSH captures the imagination and play of the gender fluidity of childhood and gives kids glamorous, positive, and unabashedly queer role models. Okay, so at least here they admit the fact that the concept of gender fluidity is based on the imagination of kids and not based in reality. We got that. The Drag Queen Story Hour organization continues to state their goal in this way. In spaces like this, kids are able to see people who defy rigid gender restrictions and imagine a world where people can present as they wish, where dress up is real. Okay, so if I get this right here, they're trying to help kids to see that they don't have to grow up, that they don't have to embrace the harsh truth of reality. No, instead, they can just continue to play dress up forever. I don't know that that's going to work out well for anyone. Now, as we consider these stated goals, I can't help but to wonder if there's more to it than just this. And, you know, I have no doubt that there are some drag queens who truly just want to help kids to develop and maintain a sense of wonder. And yet I'm also certain that Drag Queen Story Hour is also being used by others as a way to groom kids so that they might grow up and embrace this alternative lifestyle. Now, if you think that I'm just being a judgmental Christian, then I would simply point you to the confession which was made by a drag queen named Dylan Pontiff, who was helping to organize one of these Story Hour events. It was actually October 2019 when Pontiff described the event by declaring this. He says, "This is going to be the grooming of the next generation. We are trying to groom the next generation." That's right. This event that this guy was putting together, this event that includes children as young as 3 years old, was being used to groom these kids. These kids who were brought to this event were being groomed by grown men who dress up as women. Now, in response to this, you might be thinking, yeah, but this is just one guy. That was just one event. This doesn't represent the entire organization. Well, good point, except for this. This just in. A former president of Drag Queen Story Hour Foundation was just arrested on 7 counts of child porn. That's right, Brett Blum, who according to his LinkedIn profile, served as the president and CEO of the Drag Story Hour Foundation until August 2020 when he left to become a children's court judge. He's just been arrested. Blum was arrested on Tuesday for allegedly uploading 27 images and videos of children being sexually abused on this messaging app known as Kick. And while the charges have yet to be proven in a court of law, listen, Blum has been accused of uploading the images both from his home and from his judge's chambers. After being released, Blum was then ordered to stay off social media. He was ordered to stay away from any children, well, except for, you know, the two that he and his husband have adopted. Now, in light of this breaking news, there should be no doubt in our minds that Drag Queen Story Hour isn't just a group of guys who want to help kids to develop their sense of wonder. No, instead, Drag Queen Story Hour is a Trojan horse that's being used to allow perverted pedophiles direct access to the kids that come to these events. As a matter of fact, there's actually a running list of sex offenders who are actively involved in these storytime events. For example, it was 2017 as well as 2018 when Albert Alfonso Garza took part in Drag Queen Storytime events in Houston public libraries, despite the fact that he was a convicted sexual offender who actually assaulted a boy back in 2006. And in 2019, William Travis Dees Well, he repeatedly volunteered at various DQSH events, which allowed him close access to underage children. And as it turns out, Deez is also a convicted sex offender who has sexually abused children, even as young as 4 years old. According to one report, Deez was convicted and jailed for committing sex crimes against not just one, but 4 different prepubescent children, ranging in age from 4 to 8. Now, with all this in mind, it should come as no surprise that that one gay drag queen from San Bernardino, California, actually spoke out and warned parents against these events. It was actually January 2020 when this drag queen, who performs under the name Kitty Demure, described parents who allow their kids and take their kids to participate in such events. Demure described these parents as being extremely irresponsible. Extremely irresponsible. Demure went on to support this rebuke of woke parents by asking, "Would you want a stripper or a porn star to influence your child? It makes no sense at all." Now, with this question in mind, it's sad to say that we are now living in a world where convicted pedophiles are being allowed to groom our kids in public libraries. And not only that, but now former strippers like Cardi B are given the opportunity to perform sexually explicit songs on primetime television during the Grammys as they pretend to strip on stage. I can't help but to remember something that Jesus said as I consider the way this world is headed. I'm reminded of something that he warned us about in Matthew chapter 24, where he declared this: "As the days of Noah were, so also will the coming of the Son of Man be." Or in other words, just like the days of Noah, so too the world will be just before the second coming of Christ. And just to be clear, Moses summed up the days of Noah by informing us that the Lord saw that the wickedness of man was great in the earth, and that every intent of the thoughts of his heart was only evil continually. Without debate, we're watching the world becoming this place where the wickedness of man is great on the earth, and the thoughts and the intents of the hearts of mankind is becoming more and more wicked. Knowing that the mystery of lawlessness is already at work, I encourage you, let's guard our hearts and let's guard our homes from the indoctrination of those who want to normalize the sexual sins that the Lord has explicitly condemned. At the same time, we must remember that we're all guilty of sin. We're all sinners. And therefore, we can rejoice in knowing that the Lord is ready to forgive everyone who will simply repent and trust in the cross of Christ. And with that being the case, let's continue to preach the gospel of grace to every single person, regardless of their sins. And let's continue to fight the good fight of faith, all for the glory of God.